Tata Motors and Mahindra manage landmark achievements. The global NCAP crash tested the Nexon and gave it 5 stars for adult passenger safety, and the Marazzo scored 4 on the same parameter. But is safety limited to just the crash tests and whether the cars have ABS or airbags? No. Safety also applies to two-wheelers. And safety has a long way to go in this segment. We sat down with Rajeev Kapur, who heads Steelbird Helmet, and he is also the guy at the helm of the Helmet Manufacturers Association of India. And what does he have to say about safety? This is what he has to say about safety. Safety. It is something that wasn't really on the minds of people for the longest time, but it has been gaining ground and people are becoming more and more aware about safety in their vehicles. That is exactly what we are going to talk about today. We have with us Mr. Rajeev Kapur, the guy at the helm of Steelbird Helmets, and he's also the guy who runs the entire operations and the planning committee of the Helmets Association of India. Thank you very much for being with us, Mr. Kapoor. Now, to kick things off, safety is now gaining popularity in the minds of people, and it's not just the vehicular safety, but also the pedestrian safety. So I would like to know from you, what exactly are your thoughts on safety overall? And as I said, not just about vehicular, but also pedestrian safety.
Yes, right now, the government is very serious about the safety. You talk, each and every media, news channel, ministry, everybody is talking about road safety today. Road safety become a very important aspect in our country. All big OEMs, Honda, Yamaha, Hero, Royal Enfield, everybody is concerned about the safety. Safety for the riders, safety for the human beings, safety for our own Indians, which is very, very important. Now everybody want good helmets. Everybody want the cars with seat belt, cars with airbags, more safe, because all are concerns about their life.
No, and very very crucial point you bring up over here, that people now value safety, but they also value better level of safety. So over here, I have a very strong sort of a view. Our Indian helmets, sadly the non-ISI ones we are going to talk about later, because that's again a very big debate point. But even the ISI helmets, and you being the manufacturers of the possibly the biggest helmet you know, brand that we have in India as a homegrown brand, there is still that notion that only the ISI mark helmets are going to be available and should be made available in India. The DOT and Snell certifications, which are we all know they're much better in terms of their certification levels, testing levels and everything. I mean, I just want to hear from you why and what are the reasons.
Okay, I explain you why all this is happening. First of all, government has already issued a draft notification.
That's right.
That in India, there should be only ISI mark helmet should be wear by the two-wheeler riders.
Sure.
Now, ISI mark. Industrial helmets are also ISI mark. Coal mine helmets. Many helmets are ISI mark. So, government has made a specific for two-wheeler riders, ISI mark with two-wheeler helmet.
Yeah.
So, now all the helmets from 15th of January 2019, all the manufacturers has to produce as per the new standards. Now, about DOT, about Snell, about European standards and everything. They can come to India. There is no problem. They just have to take the homologation. Like we export to Europe. When we export to Europe, European government come to India,
right.
Like our ministry, like our BIS, their Department of Transportation come to India, they visit our factory, they audit our factory, they homologate our factory. Same thing happens if you go to Japan, same thing happens if you go to Sri Lanka, same thing happens if you go to Singapore, you go to Malaysia, you go to Indonesia. There are all these countries, even you go to Vietnam, you have to take their approval from the government. So when all Snell, DOT, European standards helmets are coming to India, government is not denying. They are saying you have to take the approval from us. So you should also carry the ISI mark.
Yeah, but over here, I'll sort of pause you, because even our helmet testing standards, we know that we are in shambles over there, because we were doing a little bit of an investigative report and we found out that at least in the Delhi NCR region, there are really almost like tin sheds that are assigned to do the duties of helmet testing, and that's really not done. You guys, of course, have a really decent factory and you do the testing on your own. Very appreciable. But the other market that we're talking about, and the passing of the quality levels from the government's point of view, the testing facilities are not really controlled to the level that they should be, and they're not really equipped to the level that they should be.
The difference is only the value of G's. Okay, value of impact, nothing else. Retention system is the same, means the strap system is the same. Visor testing is almost the same, but we have to improve more. We are doing it. In impact, in European it is 275G, in India it is 400G, but the equipment is the same. The anvils are the same. Everything is the same. On the same equipment you can test European standard as well as Indian standard, no problem. We have all the equipments in central laboratory. We have many laboratories where these equipments are there. At ARI Pune, the biggest laboratory and testing facility of India, are also having those equipments.
And I think on that note, it's going to be a nice time to shift into our next segment. But thank you very much, Mr. Kapur. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
Thanks, Ashish. Thanks. Thank you.